All right, people, it's Chaos. One game win streak over 6,000 BC. Let's get it in. Who's going to ride that short bus? Jacinto. Jack into 13. Fuck him. Who's he going to be? Right now, you know, it's smashing in the studio. We're hailing from East Oakland, California. Yeah, we just played the Spurs and made someone quit. Down the seven digits, call up Bridget, her man's a plus she got fringe, yo, I can dig it. Here's a swigging, you know it's frigid. I got him chilling in the cooler, break out the ruler. That's the baddest I ever seen. The weather's heating, Cali, it makes it feel like Maui. Now we feel the good vibration. So many females, so much inspiration. I get inspired by the too. Up front, you. If you hang with the punk crew, I roam the strip for when I find one.
The city of brotherly love, home of the Liberty Bell, where the 76ers are looking to take on a Western Conference opponent. Now a chance to check out tonight's starting lineups. And breaking down the game, let's take a look here at Manu Ginobili.
And another one of his really special talents is coming up with steals at the moment a ball handler picks up his dribble and is getting into a shooting motion. He's got excellent timing in that regard.
Only one game away from San Antonio here. The Spurs will be back home for the next one. They're faced now with what is probably the easiest part of their schedule. They've got a lot of home games on the docket, but they can't take anything, guys, for granted.
They've been playing a lot of basketball lately, Kevin. This is their third game in 4 days. The league didn't make it easy for them when they set up the schedule like this.
Yeah, but every team deals with this. They might need to lean on their bench a bit more, but they can't make any excuses.
And yes, sir, that one drops.
And they're just raining threes on both ends.
Boy, I love the answer. You come at me with the three, I'm coming right back with my own triple. Solid work on the back end of that play.
Yeah, finish hard with two hands on the stuff.
Yeah, nothing extravagant, guys, but again, no need on that one.
And the Spurs with possession. Philadelphia getting their last shot to go. And count the basket. He was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more.
Guys, that's just really unstoppable. He poses a ton of matchup problems for whomever he's facing.
The Spurs shooting their first free throw of the night. Now let's find out what head coach Greg Popovich had to say to Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, I asked him what strategy they were going to use at the offensive end, and he told me that they did not want to have to rely on their perimeter game. Instead, he plans to exploit what he described as a mismatch on the interior, saying, quote, "We have the talent inside to make things very difficult on them. We're going to use it." Kevin?
And as always, Doris, thank you. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Spurs will take it. First 1:30 gone here in the first quarter. The Spurs have gotten their first three shots to go in for them to start off this game. Parker dishes to Aldridge. Green. Good, and Aldridge gets the assist. Green's got five.
And early on, they looked great. They've made all four of their shots to start this game.
He dishes it to Covington. Pulls it up. The good-looking shot from the wing. 7 points in the game.
You know, you're going to have success when you can start out shooting 80% from the game. So, early offensively, they've been great. That's the way you like to start.
Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession. Here we are in November. Let's see how things are shaking out in the West early in the season. Taking a look at Houston and checking out Philadelphia. They're tied right now. Looking at Philadelphia, they took the win in their last game against the Indiana Pacers.
And how about the game plan that was constructed for that one? I mean, it was apparent how powerless the D was to stop
it. Yeah, that's a good way to put it. I mean, they just didn't have an answer for anything they threw at
them. And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was. I mean, a tight game like this one, you'd think they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end than that.
Here's Leonard, laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Leonard's got five now.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last four buckets allowed have come from very close range.
Yeah, high percentage shots are what they are getting in terms of the attempts, and that's just not going to get it done. They've got to figure it out.
And the 76ers decide to take their first time out here. And this matchup with the Spurs, it's their first meeting of the season. Stauskas is checked in for Philadelphia. And both free throws good for Covington.
Well done again. He doesn't have the same problems at the line that plague some of the NBA's other big men.
Parker double teamed. Dishes to Leonard. Fires from deep. It's hauled in by Saric.
Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
They get it again. McConnell passes to Embiid, and he banks in the layup. Embiid's got his first points of the game.
Another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively so far.
Yeah, and I think we're going to see them operating a lot of their offense from the interior today.
And it's out of bounds. The Spurs able to retain possession here. Gasol kicks to Aldridge. Outside, Green. Parker. Back to Green. For three. And it's good on the assist by Parker. Green's got 8 points.
And you know, at the end of the day, Steve, you just have to respect his overall defensive acumen. I mean, it's not just one thing he does well at that end. He knows how to guard from A to Z.
It's like everybody is in a rhythm right now. And double stuff here early on.
Both teams playing downhill. You know, coaches say that all the time. You want to play downhill. Well, at some point, you think somebody's got to cool off in this one, right?
And they double up Gasol. Outside Leonard. Just 5 on the clock. Gasol setting the pick for Leonard. Another shot. That's good.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Well, I agree with you. 4 of their last 5 baskets have been exactly of that variety.
Now here's Leonard. He's got 7. Parker kicks to Leonard. Leonard draws the double with the lead pass. On the wing, Green. The offensive rebound. Here's Gasol, the layup off target.
Not too much congestion in the lane. I think he could have gotten a better shot that time, no question.
Embiid. And here's Covington from the arc. That's good. Covington's got 15.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist number. And theirs are fantastic.
Just beautiful when they play the game like this.
And let's check out some stats. Here are the numbers for Covington. 13th in three-point field goal percentage, and he's in the top 20 in steals, bringing that focus and intensity at both ends.
And nobody's able to guard him out there. I mean, defenders have been trying to get physical with him, but
why are these people
bother him.
On
he just
the
shrugs
court?
It off.
There's people on the court.
Leonard dishes to Parker. And we have an intentional foul there. I wish I could say why.
That one's pretty strange. I mean, no idea what got into his head right there.
So San Antonio goes with a fresh five on the floor. Shot's good by LeVert.
And the lead goes right back. What a seesaw affair we've got going on.
This game's right there for the taking, but neither team can quite grab hold of it. It's a slippery bar of soap there. Somebody's got to take charge here.
Embiid the screen.
Well, he's got to watch himself now. I mean, that's two fouls already, and he can't afford another.
76ers have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2-for-2.
And last season, 77% from the line. They usually get the job done there.
You know, this season versus last, they've seen a decrease in their success at the free throw line.
Well, it was the San Antonio Spurs winning their last game against the Suns.
And, guys, that was their night. I mean, it seemed like everything they shot went in.
It happens that way sometimes, guys. It was just one of those games where the hot shooting of a couple of players became contagious, and nobody was stopping.
And Philadelphia making a change here. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. 76ers trailing. Pass to Holmes. Mills with the steal. And Ginobili with a clear path to the rack. Here's Korkmaz. Makes it off the glass. Clarkie talked about a back and forth game. This is the definition of
that. Yeah, no doubt about it, Kevin. I mean, not even through the first half, and it's been one heck of a battle.
You have to love these kinds of games, scoring wise, keeping everybody on their toes.
And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Spurs lead by two. And back with the start of the second quarter in just a moment. So far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for San Antonio.
They definitely had a hot hand from three-point range. Always nice to get off to a good start.
They've been distributing the ball really well tonight, too. I mean, a decent number of assists so far for them.
On the floor for San Antonio, Mills and Manu at the guards. Anderson is out there at Bledsoe. And it's Gay in at the three spot. So the whistle blows on the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there.
And, you know, against him, Steve, as an opponent, you need to make sure you're making smart, crisp passes because he's so good at picking off the sloppy, loose ones.
Joel Anthony's checked in for San Antonio.
Joel Anthony, oh, yeah.
Spurs trail by three. Back to Anderson. The feet to Mills. The tray. And that one's good. Mills has got his second bucket of the night.
D there, guys, was pretty much non-existent. I mean, you can't leave a good shooter like that open.
Embiid kicks to Covington. A three-pointer off the mark.
Come on, Mr. Covington.
San Antonio's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Now here's Mills. He's guarded closely. Anderson passes to Murray. Six on the shot clock. Back to Anderson. Simmons pulls it in.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that
one. That's his first. Second team foul.
And we're now about a minute and a half into the second quarter. And Kyle Anderson gets the whistle that time. That'll be his second foul of the game. Here's Covington. Against Indiana, he was really on his game. Baseline try. Simmons. Sarge dishes to Embiid. From past the arc. Can't hit. The Spurs have gone 1-3 to start out the second quarter. Passes it to Mills.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
Yeah, and I like this call because you want the refs in that situation. If there's any doubt, err on the side of giving the benefit of the doubt to the offensive player. That should have been a block, and it was.
Here's Simmons.
Man, he got fancy with that one, didn't he?
Yeah, maybe trying to give them the momentum boost they need to break this game open.
I tell you what, I like that, though, guys. Some coaches might not want you to make a play like that, but I tell you what, when you got the skills like that, I say go for it.
Philadelphia's gotten a success rate of just over 50% from three-point tonight. 4 of 7 shooting. Parker outside. Leonard. Here's Gasol. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
And Clark, it's a strategy that has served them well during the course of this first half.
San Antonio's gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight. 50% exactly. Parker double team. Embiid against Gasol. Let's go. Philadelphia takes possession. Here we are in November, and let's see how things are going out east in the early season. Look at the Celtics. And of course, there's the 76ers. 2.5 games back. The 76ers making a switch here. And Philadelphia calls time here. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated or hydrate for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point. Without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have got to be hydrated.
To the middle, Korkmaz. Aldridge is covering, and McConnell gets it to go. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Leonard attacking Green, and he lays it straight in. Green's got 10 points in the game. Here's McConnell, 5 points in the game. Stauskas, the pass to Holmes. He feeds it to Stauskas. McConnell. And that one hits back iron.
You know, not only is the game neck and neck and tight, but the rebounding battle is too. Extremely close on the board.
It's been brutal in terms of the physicality down low.
Inside. And it's out of bounds. The 76ers able to retain possession here.
Well, early on in the season still, but Kevin, it's time to take a look at where the 76ers sit right now in the league stats. Second in assists, fourth in three-point field goal percentage. And they're in the top 10 getting into the passing lanes and coming up with steals.
And let's go back to their assists for a second. When you're sharing the ball like they have, I think it really builds chemistry and trust. This is a group that really plays for each other. His shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons they're up in this game.
Trying his luck deep. Another miss by Philadelphia. Parker kicks to Gay. Leonard sets a screen for Gay. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. Backing up the points down low, well, that's exactly what these guys have done this season. Check out the top scoring big men in the NBA. This is his first trip to the line tonight.
Yeah, it's good to see him with his free throw percentage up over 80.
And guys, I think that's a tribute to his work ethic. I mean, it's not by accident that he's enjoying the success he is at the free throw line.
Just solid, really one of the very best there is at the free throw line.
Number 7, Green with the block, and they get it back. And good on the basket. Look at Johnson's got his first bucket in this one.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
Aldridge backing in. Green. And too long on the shot.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively.
It has been nip and tuck through the first half.
No kidding. I mean, neither team has been able to hold the lead for any length of time, guys.
So close.
Exactly, guys. The way it's seesawed back and forth, unbelievable.
That's a clean look they gave him there, fellas, and he drains those.
It's Redick on the wing. The dish to Johnson. Plays it up and banks it in. Johnson's got 4 points this quarter.
I mean, that's almost automatic anytime he can get the ball in that position.
Outside Leonard. Three from game.
Whoa, what a no good on the buzzer beater. So
and the first half comes to a... Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far.
You look at what Covington has done so far.
18 points, and he's drained 4 3-pointers.
Oh!
I don't know that this is the time for that kind of flair. In a close game, the important thing is the 2 points, not the dramatic.
Oh, come on, Clark, you had to go for it, didn't he?
Hey, he's an athlete, and I can't fault him for that one. Although, if he missed it, I might have. So I'll tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
The 76ers lead. That sets off a five-game tour for him. And he gets the bucket. Sarge has got his first points of the night. San Antonio's guarded the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed 5 of them. Parker kicks to Aldridge. Back to Parker. Inside to Gasol. That one goes. Count it. The 76ers shooting is beautiful right now. 60% for the game. Pretty much everyone out there has been stroking it. Simmons dishes to Embiid. He kicks it to Simmons. Embiid with a screen on Leonard. Goes up off the pick. And Embiid throws it down.
And how about the execution on that play? The screen was set up in exactly the right spot.
And the finish wasn't too bad either.
Perfectly designed and perfectly executed.
Here's Green. That's short off the rim.
He's the one guy that I think the defense is going to live with being open.
And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul. Shot misses. He'll be shooting two. The 76ers shooting their 7th and 8th attempts at the foul line tonight. The first one falls.
Outstanding foul shooting in this game. And that confidence can be infectious. They're taking care of business on the charity stripe.
And so he's able to get one of two.
Yeah, but the main thing is the two-possession lead is secure.
Right side, Gasol. And they double up Gasol. Here's Aldridge. Battles through traffic and lays it in. Aldridge has got 9.
Another area where he excels is on one of the most fundamental plays in basketball, the pick and roll. He will lower the boom on the defender with a solid screen and then is terrific at rolling into space and getting the basket.
Covington with the bucket.
Big on Mr. Covington.
Long range, and if he keeps getting those opportunities, he better take them.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game.
And did not seem happy about how things are going on right now and maybe wants to make some changes.
I agree. I mean, just was not comfortable with the way things were set up at that particular time. And in that case, I think it's the right thing to do.
And the Spurs making a change here. Gaze check in.
And how about the numbers here for Embiid? 10th in rebounding. And, of course, rim protection always at a premium. That's an important part of his game. Top 20 in blocks per.
Boy, he's unbelievably driven, and he competes with you for the full 48 minutes. Glass eater.
Here's Parker. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Number 7. And this is his 3rd trip to the line tonight. First one falls for him. Good on both. Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Now, here's Parker. Not a lot of room. Here's Gabe. And Embiid pulls it down. Embiid's got three rebounds now in this one.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound department, but that oftentimes is all it takes.
Especially, Greg, when you're scoring the ball at a decent clip the way they have. I mean, they've done exactly what's necessary to take the lead.
And here's Covington from the arc. Rebound San Antonio.
But only the first miss of the second half. They've come out here with authority.
Gaze double. Here's Green. Lays it up, and despite of the excellent defense at that, Green's got 12 points in the game. Sarge with it. Gay picks him up defensively. And the shot goes in from Embiid.
And every once in a while, he'll show up and give you some great moves around the hoop.
Let's the three fly, and it's Green missing. Philadelphia leading by 7. Again, Philadelphia.
Ooh, that is a tough shot.
San Antonio's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Double team on Parker. Aldridge. Green kicks to Gay. To Simmons. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. Back to Alder. Brown. Got a piece of it. The dive for the ball. And that'll be Philadelphia as it goes out of bounds. 76ers retain possession. So San Antonio goes with a fresh 5 on the floor. Timeout called, the 76ers. Joel Embiid. .157 left here in the third quarter.
Defensive foul. Kyle Anderson. That's his second personal foul.
.153 left to play in the third. Here's Simmons. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
Pretty. That was just a nice-looking reverse jam right there.
Use the rim, Clark, to protect the ball, I think, too, a little bit.
Yeah, did a nice job with it.
And, guys, how about the awareness there with that finish in traffic?
Here's Laverne. It's blocked. It's stolen. Anderson outside. .119 left in the third quarter. And here's Mills from the arc. Out of bounds, Philadelphia takes possession. The 76ers leading by 11. Here's Simmons. Here's Embiid.
Maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that.
And we know he's capable of those memorable dunks.
Yeah, and when he's got a lead like that, why not take a few chances? A lot more engaging and entertaining than just doing the old ho-hum one-hander. Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
And he takes the fantastic lead pass and scores for the swing.
They are putting the hammer down. A huge lead right now.
Yeah, and it doesn't matter if we're talking about their offense or their defense. I mean, it's all been good.
And Philadelphia making a change here. 44 seconds left in the third. Feeds it to Mills to stop the drought. That falls. Nice feed that time for Manu Ginobili. Mills has got 9.
Love the assist. I mean, he knew exactly where that bounce pass had to be to create that opportunity.
The 76ers have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances. Second free throw, no good. Spurs trail by 13. Anderson outside. A 3. The Spurs rebound. And Laverne kicks to Ginobili. Sinks the triple. Ginobili's got his first 3 points of the game. Here's Embiid. Oh, and there's the one-handed jam.
Back a few more points onto their lead with the power.
That's going to town hard.
Yes, sir.
Symbolic there as well of the effort here tonight.
Here's Covington. From down in the low post, it goes. Covington's got 25 points.
Mr. Covington,
three quarters away, double digits, it may... Welcome back as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. Not exactly a nail-biter here, but you never know. Now let's take a moment to get your guys' take on the scoring so far for Philadelphia.
Anytime you get as many points in the paint as they have, you know you've got a good thing going, and you just want to keep it going.
And I also love the way they move the basketball. Their passing has been outstanding here in the second half.
Okay, now let's reset our lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this fourth quarter. On the court for San Antonio, they've got Ginobili, and it's Aldridge in at the center, filling out the middle. And he gets the bucket. 16 points for Joel Embiid.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
That's not the kind of streak you want to be part of defensively. Tighten it up, fellas.
Now Murray. Now the pass to Mills. Shot clock at 6. No coverage that time.
And really, as the three-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
Yeah, and they either have been unwilling or unable to take that shot away.
Spurs making a switch here. Three. 60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Spurs will take it.
And I think he was surprised to see that pass coming his way and just really reacted too late.
Murray kicks to Leonard from the arc. But they'll get another chance. Outside, Green. Aldridge inside. And finally they hit one.
And you're not going to pass up that kind of
play. And Embiid throws it down.
A one-hand slam is sweet when it's his hand doing the slam.
Oh, yeah, he is so smooth, even on a power finish like that.
And really, that's what makes him unique, that combination of power and polish.
And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
Robert Covington. At the line for two.
The first free throw is good. Dwayne Dedmon's checked in for Joel Anthony. And he makes both free throws. And we've made our way through just over a minute and a half in this fourth quarter. Green kicks to Parker. There's the bucket. Good.
Even though there's a height disadvantage, he's still able to go up and over his man.
Well, he's fearless. I mean, there's nothing that concerns him. No matter what the matchup is, he's a guy that doesn't back down. He's beyond being intimidated.
They blow the whistle just as he gets it off. That's 2 points with a chance for another one at the stripe.
Their interior defense has been dismal.
Yeah, they're losing the battle in the paint.
And that one misses. Spurs trail by 15. Kicks to Gasol. He dishes it to Parker. Now the 76ers on the break. And he's going up for the alley-oop.
No hesitation at all on that alley-oop. Saw his teammate with the pass to the hoop. And bang! Popped it right up there for him.
And he was ready for it. Elevated. Made the catch. You saw the result.
And you know what, though? I like the fact that he still chose that conservative finish there. Just making sure he got the deuce.
And he gets it to go.
And he got loose from the three-point range in the first half and showing signs here that he's still got the flow in the second.
And that'll be San Antonio as it goes out of bounds. Spurs retain possession. Here's Leonard. Will it go?
You got to look to move the ball inside more, I think. The three isn't there like it was in the first half, so you got to be able to show some balance in your offense. If the three's not there, take what the defense gives you.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team. The second he got around the pick and shook his man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy dude. Very, very well done.
They get it back. There's Embiid. Here we go, one-on-one. Kicks it out to Leonard from 17 feet out. There's the three. Shot misses. And it's Philadelphia the other way.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
And it's been a well-rounded performance. I mean, strong rebounding has certainly been at the center of it, but it's been good on a number of levels.
Here's Green. And it's rebounded by Covington. Here's Philadelphia. They're on a 13-4 run right now. Pass to McConnell. From deep three-point range. And Ginobili pulls it down. Leonard's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
And the 76ers making a change here. Number 7. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
And that's the dagger right there. Really the nail in the coffin.
I'd agree. I mean, they've done a great job of sealing this one, closing it out. And they never backed off, even with the big lead. I love to see teams do that.
Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over. They're down by 22. 1:52 left to play in the final quarter. Poked away. And that'll be San Antonio as it goes out of bounds. Spurs retain possession.
And really no choice but to lunge for that pass to make sure it didn't get through.
Yeah, and that was important. Probably would have been a quick 2 points if he doesn't get a hand on it and knock it out of bounds.
McConnell passes to Embiid. The rim-rattling two-handed jam.
A one-man show offensively.
He thought he had that one clean, but the ref saw it differently. They'll count the basket.
Listen to the reaction of the fans after that call.
Really safe to say they were not too happy about that.
McConnell passes to Holmes. And that one's good.
Three consecutive baskets have come right at the rim. Defense had better start buckling down and tightening up.
Guys, they are getting exposed in terms of their low post defense. +8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative. They've played, I think, with more purpose so far.
And the 76ers will go for a different look here. And Embiid drops them both.
He's been to the line here more than in the first. I thought he was a bit tentative in that first, but I like the aggressiveness he's showing here now.
Ginobili kicks to Anderson. And Robert Covington picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
That's his first foul. First team.
Down low. Philadelphia's gone downtown 13 times in this game, and they're just over 50%. 7 of 13 on threes. To the inside. Great communication on the alley-oop. Philadelphia's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Dishes it to Simmons. Puts the lead pass in front of him. And the Spurs pushing it up now. There to miss the pass to Gay.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
Robert Covington.
Free throw drops for Covington. And both free throws good for Covington. 35 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Ginobili draws the double. Mills. Spurs working the ball around now. And here's the fast break. The feed now to Simmons. And he pings it home with one hand.
That one will seal the deal there. They've exploded here at the end.
Boy, I love the serious killer instinct they've shown. Finishing strong.
A slam by Sarge.
Well, they're going to walk out of here with a win and send this crowd home happy.
Yeah, you know, it was a real solid performance for them in a lot of areas. I mean, they should be proud of their work tonight.
And the first one at the line is good. The Spurs making a switch here. And both free throws good for Mills. Here's Simmons. He passes to Covington. A off the mark there with the three-point shot. So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. This game may not have been the most exciting we've ever seen, but you have to appreciate just what a clinical performance they put on.
Yeah, they were the superior team in every department, in every category to me, Kevin. I know their fans loved it and appreciated it.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching as we present our Jordan Player of the Game, Joel Embiid.
Clutch, Mr. Covington, Embiid, Simmons,
Nas, yeah. Freedom of jail inserted. A baby's being born. Same time a man is. The beginning and end. As far as rap go, it's only natural. I explain my plateau and also what defines my name. First it was nasty, but times have changed. Actually now I'm the artist, but hardcore my signs for pain. I spent time.
Two games.